What is up, guys? I'm Daddy Gamer Fred, back again with another Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu, Pokemon Let's Go Eevee tour video. Now, in this video, we're going to be going over Pallet Town, just walking around and just seeing the sights and kind of going over and giving my thoughts on how everything looks inside of the game. Now, as you guys know, Pokemon Yellow is my favorite game of all time. It, to me, is the definitive perfect Pokemon game. Now, again, that could probably be due to nostalgia and it being literally one of the first games I ever completed and being a big part of my life growing up, generation one. So I am hugely a fan of those games, and including a fan of Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee, because it's essentially a remake of that game to me, with its little minor differences and stuff like that that this game is bringing to, you know, the Pokemon franchise and as a whole, but also the update that is doing for Pokemon Yellow itself. Pallet Town is a huge part of Pokemon Yellow because it's the birthplace of your characters, the birthplace of your character in Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee. This is where you're from. So of course it does hold a special spot in my heart to see it, you know, with these brand new graphics, full HD, you know, everything in color, even with a Pikachu running behind you in the beginning areas of the game. It's incredible. It's incredible to see this stuff, see your mom, everything look like this fleshed out. I am kind of happy with how the initial house looks in the beginning. Still kind of weird that your mom doesn't have a room in the house. I thought with the upgrade they could kind of fix that issue, but you know, it's still one bedroom upstairs and that bedroom happens to be yours. And it's so cool with the little touches that it does have with the initial Gengar Nidorino fight that is in the intro of the original Pokemon Red Blue games. That's kind of cool that that image is, you know, hung on the wall just like the original trainer had, I believe, in Pokemon Origins as well. So it's pretty cool. The room, pretty simple, has a Nintendo Switch. We've seen the room. It looks pretty cool. What I did like, and I also want to point out in this version of the game, and I don't know if this was done intentionally just for my character, because as you guys know, I'm Black and Latino, and I made my skin color like almost the caramel, not the darkest you can make it in the game, but they also made my mother the same skin color as me, even with the same hair color. And I thought that was pretty cool that they did that. They changed my mother's skin color to represent a player that may be darker. Now again, I'm not sure if they do that to all of the game characters, if your mother is that color regardless across the board, but I thought that was pretty cool nonetheless that the mother is not just, you know, white in the game, that she's could be a mix of both per se. And then stepping out of the house, moving over to the rival's house, I kind of lackluster of this, you know, of this house. I feel like this house could have used the same layout as my house, as the, you know, the player's house, by giving it upstairs, giving your rival Trace a room to kind of give him more character, to, you know, deepen the lore per se about the trainer house. Now I believe in the Red, Blue, Yellow games, the rival never really has a house as well. It's just the first floor anyway. They don't have like their own room with distinct, you know, styles and stuff like that. I was kind of, you know, hoping that they upgraded that. I believe in Auras, Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire, and even Ruby and Sapphire in the original games, we seen an upgraded house for the rival where they had it upstairs and stuff like that. So nothing too much to see here inside of the rival's house. I do know this, that there is a picture of the rival on the first floor on like a little bench, a little table, which is kind of cool. It kind of defines the house. It kind of like, hey, this is, you know, the person's house. Hopefully this picture won't be randomly in somebody else's house and later on in the game, but I do think that's a cool touch, but again, still missing its flair and, you know, its pop per se. Now, one thing that I have to point out that to me is kind of a letdown with the Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee games. Again, you know, with it being a remake and the camera style being kind of identical to what we've seen from the original Game Boy games, it's kind of upsetting that when you pass behind a house, your character gets lost. You don't know what's behind there. You don't know if there's items or anything. It's 2018. Like, I'm pretty sure they could have easily done a transparent look to the building so you could at least keep your eye on the character when he's moving behind solid objects like that. Or if they didn't want to, you know, allow us to turn the camera, but they should at the part parts like this, they should have had the camera turn or gave us an option to, you know, to move the camera around three-dimensional to see the back of these houses. Because again, that's one thing to me that would have completed this and made this incredible to, you know, see a living world in all sides, not just this one panned shot that, you know, is kind of designed in a certain way. And it kind of feels cheap, to be honest, but nonetheless, still beautiful to see. Now, obviously, let's talk about the crown jewel of Pallet Town, and that is Professor Oak's lab, which again still looks identical to what it looked like in previous games, but it does get a visual upgrade, obviously being moved into the Nintendo Switch compared to how it looked on the Game Boy 20 years ago. One thing I want to point out that I mentioned in the quote unquote review series that I'm doing, and I'll have that linked in the description below if you want to check it out. There's a machine in the back room, in the back corner, the back left corner, that has 6 Pokeballs in it, and it looks like it's connected to another machine or some kind. And from my understanding, there is no use to this machine. When you talk to it, it just says, you know, there's Pokeballs and machine. I'm not too sure what it says actually, but I'm hoping that this machine gets used in the future, maybe down the line when the Gen 8 games come out, and this machine will probably be the way to transfer Pokemon from Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee onward to the Gen 8 games. I think this would be a cool area to do it, because again, the Pokemon centers in these games don't have computers and don't have an area to trade. Everything is kind of done in menus in the communication tab inside of the start menu. But if they were to have it that you can trade by going to a place in game, I think this might be the place. And I think I just found out what they said. I went into it in the footage, and it says there are Pokeballs in a mysterious machine. Again, that got me thinking about what could be this mysterious machine, because of the fact that it's, you know, it's leading on that it's a mysterious machine. It's not saying what it is or, you know, giving a clear definition to what it is. Hopefully there is an explanation in the future. That's just my thoughts on it as it stands now. I think Professor Oak looks incredible in this version of the game. It's the best we ever seen him. One thing I don't like, again, initially popping this game in, is the NPCs in the overworld kind of look lifeless and just like have a dead stare and look like they're staring into nothing literally while you're walking around, you know. And that's something that I would want the Gen 8 games or future games in the Pokemon series to fix. It's like they give us this world and it feels like a living, breathing world with the Pokemon, but then the NPCs, the characters, the human characters anyway that we've seen in the world, are lifeless and just look like dolls waiting in place, waiting for you to interact with them. And that kind of throws you out and makes you feel like you're in a video game. So I would love to see Professor Oak just, you know, sitting on the computer, drinking a cup of coffee, you know, stretching or whatever, you know what I'm saying, getting up, looking at charts and stuff like that, just to kind of show that he's not just in here waiting for you to come in and interact with him, that, you know, he's actually doing work and stuff like that. Same thing with the NPCs, you know, they just in here just staring at bookshelves and not really paying attention or doing anything significant. One thing I do want to point out is that there is another Pokeball on the desk outside of the Pikachu in the Eevee that you and your trainer grab. No answer yet to what's in that Pokeball, and I'm hoping that maybe it's a link to Gen 8. I'm still holding out that hope that we still have teases in this game to the next games that we don't know about, you know, that wasn't found in the Datamon, even though the Datamon, they did find everything. But hopefully DLC or something like that coming on down the line will pop that information open or be downloaded via a patch and stuff like that. But that's just me hopeful thinking. Let me know what you think about that, as well as Pallet Town as a whole, in the description below. As you guys know, I answer all comments, and this is going to be a full discussion piece with all of the towns, with my thoughts on the game. I'm doing a full review broken up into multiple parts, and this is just, again, the Pallet Town portion. Let me know your thoughts of the visual upgrade to Pallet Town, anything you thought they could have maybe add, like a Pokemon Center or a Mart to Pallet Town to kind of give it more life. Or do you like the, you know, the two building with the lab look and feel of Pallet Town? Or do you think they could have done more to kind of add it to make it feel more lived in as a, you know, breathing world in this Pokemon universe? So like always, guys, peace. I'm gonna see you guys in the comments, and I'm gonna see you guys on the next one. Like always, guys, I'm Daddy Gamer Fred on Instagram and Twitter, and you guys can bring the conversation there. I'm the American Gamer in Switzerland right here. here on YouTube. And yes, I'm going to be doing a ton of videos just like this one. So if you enjoy, please hit that subscribe button. Also, hit the like button. It does help me out a ton as far as growing the channel is concerned. Ring the bell if you want to be notified on the next time I drop a video. Peace. I'm going to see you guys on the next one.